In this week's Tuesday Photoshop tutorial, we're going to take a look at how the patch tool can often be even better than content-aware fill. Hi, I'm Dave Cross. In last week's video, I showed a way that you can make content-aware fill even better by isolating the areas that you want to use when it does the content-aware fill. But even then, sometimes it still doesn't work in a couple of scenarios. The first one is, if you bring in a file that's a smart object, say from Camera Raw, content-aware fill can't work on a smart object. So right away, that's gonna eliminate that from being used at all. But even when you do try and use it, if there's a very significant pattern that repeats, sometimes content-aware fill doesn't do that great a job of capturing that pattern. It takes an awful lot of effort to get it to work. So here's how you can work around that thanks to the patch tool. So here's the image that I want to use, and it's a Camera Raw file. And I like to open my Camera Raw files as smart objects. So once again, that's going to present a problem. Because if I even attempt to use content-aware fill, you'll see fill is completely grayed out. Even if I add a new layer, you cannot use content-aware fill on a new layer. See, it's grayed out, so you can't do it. Now, just to show you the problem you can have, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to duplicate this temporarily and do something you normally wouldn't see me do, which is rasterize, because I want to show you that even if you try using content-aware fill, sometimes it may not work all that well. So I'm going to try and get it to fill this area. So we'll go to Fill and Content-Aware and click OK. That's going to do its calculation. See, it's done an okay job up here, but then it just doesn't know quite what to do here. So you can imagine it would take quite a few tries to get this to work. And even there, it looks to me like it's not quite accurate. So that again is part of the potential problem with using content-aware fill where there's a definite pattern. Now in this case, again, because it's a smart object, as you saw, I couldn't use fill anyway. So one of the advantages of the patch tool, regardless of comparing it to content-aware fill, is that you can put it on a blank layer. So you can still use a smart object below and put the results of the patch tool on that blank layer. So I'm gonna add a layer. Then we'll take our patch tool, and I usually just try and do a little bit at a time. I don't want to go too much. And here's the first advantage of the patch tool is as I drag, I'm actually seeing a preview. So I'm getting to actually choose the place to use as my patch. And I can that way match up the existing pattern till I see what I like, and then I let go. Then it does its calculations and tries to do the content-aware fill, but using the area that I indicated. And overall, I would say it's done pretty well, but there are a couple, there's at least one spot in here that's not quite as good. So here's the other big advantage of the patch tool. This is a pretty rare situation compared to most tools in Photoshop. In almost every other tool in Photoshop, the options that you set in the options bar mean before you use the tool. Once you've used the tool, you can't change those options. You have to undo and start again. The patch tool, it's almost like these options are live, meaning you can move the patch, wait for it to do its content-aware fill, and then try some different settings to see if it improves it. The structure is a scale of 1 to 7, and this determines how much it should reflect the existing pattern. So I want the number to be at 7 in this case because I want it to very closely adhere. If I put the number down to 1, you'll see that it won't follow the pattern quite as closely, and you'll see that's where you get that same kind of problem we had when I tried content-aware fill. So for this one, I'm going to keep it at 7, and notice how I'm not making a new patch. All I'm doing is changing the number and having it update. Color is on a scale of 0 to 10, and that allows you to determine how much you want color blending. If you enter 0, there's no color blending at all, meaning it will just do its best attempt to do the patch, but it won't pay attention to the existing colors. 10 will apply more color blending, but in this case it might have a problem with the pattern. So let's see if we put it up to 10. I'm pretty sure it's going to have an issue with trying to blend the colors. We're going to override our pattern a little bit. Yeah, that's what happens there. So we're probably going to want somewhere in the 3 to 4 range. That looks a little better there. So there's no hard and fast rule to say always use a number of 7 and 10 or 6 and 3. It's going to depend on the situation, like a lot of things in Photoshop. But the beauty of it is, again, you don't have to start with a different patch each time. You're just using the existing patch and trying different settings. So to continue now, I'd say, okay, that's pretty good. So continue, now I could say that was okay. Let's try doing a patch here now and see if we can't follow our existing pattern once again. So as you can imagine, this would take a bit of time to go through and do this, but when you think about the alternatives, first of all, if it's a smart object, you can't use content-aware fill at all. Secondly, even when you do try content-aware fill, you'll notice sometimes, no matter how many times you undo and redo, it just isn't giving you a very good result. So that's the beauty of the patch tools. First of all, it works with a smart object by applying to a separate layer, and you have the option of previewing where the patch is and adjusting it using the settings in the options bar. So I think you'll find for lots of situations, the patch tool can often be an even better choice than content-aware fill, or works very nicely in conjunction with content-aware fill if you're not quite getting the results that you want. I'm Dave Cross. Please come back next week for another Tuesday tutorial. And as always, if you like this video, please subscribe and tell your Photoshop-using friends to come on and take a look. And come back next week for another Photoshop Tuesday tutorial.